My name is John Kopchick. I'm a distinguished professor at Ohio University. My appointment is to the Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine. My lab is located in the Edison Biotechnology Institute.
Everywhere that I go, I talk about John. It's almost unheard of that I would give a lecture or a presentation to anybody without talking about John. I always highlight what he's done here, and that helps us bring in the very best students, the very best faculty, and the best researchers into our college. So John's work has elevated the college in almost anywhere that you look.
My collaborators at Aarhus have been many, and it's been going on since the mid-1990s. The first person I met, colleague, friend, is Alan Flugberg, who's now the dean of the medical school at Aarhus. And then in the mid-90s, I was just fascinating to meet a very, very good clinician, Jens Sandel Christensen. He and I were giving talks in different capitals of the countries in the world, and we became friends and colleagues. And through him, I was able to meet Jens Otto Jorgensen, a colleague of Jens Christensen. And together, the three of us went on to plan successful collaborations.
He has built a community of scholars, many of them from around the world. There's always a visiting scholar in there. He's got people coming in the lab all the time, so you have the diversity, but he also has a group of students. He's got research scientists from all over, and he really makes people enjoy being there.
We now have currently, right now, a student from Jan Fursteg. Her name is Rika Hartsberg, excuse me if I got that name wrong. But she's now here working on adipose tissue from human samples and from mouse samples to see the effect of growth hormone, if they're the same in humans and mice or different.
The drug that John invented has had a profound impact on medicine. Prior to Somavert being invented, there was no drug that was specifically a growth hormone antagonist that would treat this condition called acromegaly.
We were sitting around talking and he said, "So Darlene, do you want to change the world?" And I said, "What are you talking about? No, not really." And he said, "Well, if you don't want to change the world, you need to get out of science." He said, "You've got to want to change the world."
We do state-of-the-art science, as I told you, but we also have fun. So my colleague, when I go to visit in Aarhus, and after a day of talking science and doing scientific things, we'll always have a dinner somewhere together and have fun. And again, it's the interaction of the science, the clinical aspects of the science, and the personalities, the personal interactions, the fun that we have, that makes this an ideal collaboration.